wife and I are in our early 30s. We've been married for almost 5 years, and we don't have kids. Some people are coming up to us and starting to give us advice about children, or actually how to make children. Like, you should swim every day, or just relax, or take this vitamin, or eat peppers, or don't eat peppers, or have more sex, have less sex, or quit your job, or pretend you're riding a push bike, or stop jogging. And one misconception that I think is driving lots of this is the belief that after 35, you're walking off a cliff. Fertility just drops. This is driven by the stat that 1 out of 3 women who are 35 years old will not get pregnant within a year. This number, 1 in 3, has been used in some fairly official capacities, but you need to ask yourself the question, where does it come from? And that's what I started to look into. This number, 1 in 3, comes from France in the 1700s, where it looked at lots of people and saw how many got pregnant. But it didn't consider whether they were trying to get pregnant or even if they were sexually active. And that means that there's millions of people today who are told to get pregnant now based on a statistic, 1 in 3, that comes from a time before electricity, antibiotics, or fertility treatment. So is there a better data set we can look at? And the answer is yes. There's more up-to-date data we can use, and it tells a very different story. A more recent study considered about 800 women in Europe, and the study found that women in the late 30s who had sex at least twice a week had an 82% chance of getting pregnant within a year, compared to 86% for 27 to 34 year olds, a drop of only 4%. And essentially, there's no difference between women in the late 20s or in their 30s. Another study from Boston University followed about 3,000 Danish women. It found that of women in their late 30s, 35 to 40, 78 got pregnant within a year, compared to 84 for women 20 to 34. Again, only a slight difference. A third study from the University of North Carolina focused just on older women, women 38 or 39, and found that 80% of white women in this age bracket who were not overweight got pregnant within 6 months, with lower results for other races or people who were overweight. Most studies don't see a big drop in fertility until above the age of 40. However, we need to think not just about likelihood of getting pregnant, but complications with pregnancies, like miscarriage, high blood pressure, and chromosome issues like Down syndrome. In general, all of these things get more likely with age, but probably not as much as you think. Most of the data on miscarriages is focused on women who go through IVF pregnancies, so it's not a great source to use. However, there is good data for blood pressure and chromosome issues. For just generic genetic issues, the rate is about 1% for women 35, 2% for women who are 40, and 13% for women who are 45. Specifically for Down syndrome, it's about 1 in 500 when you're 20, 1 in 400 when you're 30, and 1 in 65 when you're 40. And finally, for blood pressure, it affects about 2% of women who are 30 and 4% of women who are 40. So the data tells us two core things. Fertility decreases with age and complications increase. But the vast majority of women at any stage in their 30s will be able to get pregnant on their own and deliver a healthy baby. As a simple guide, it's recommended to have your last child before the age of 40. After 40, you're rolling a dice. It may work out, or maybe there'll be consequences. And finally, with all of these numbers, keep in mind that these stats only represent the hundreds or thousands of women in the studies. They don't represent all women trying to conceive. Each couple is unique. I hope this video challenged your view that 35-year-olds have some type of fertility cliff and have to rush. If you want to learn more, I've included links below. Or see your doctor. Give me a thumbs up and subscribe below. Thanks for watching.